I'm Penny Carlson, and welcome to another segment of Topics in Digital Photography. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to open a Flickr account, how to upload images to that Flickr account, how to post your photos into our assignment group, and how to navigate some other basic functions in Flickr, including how to put your profile into Flickr. We'll start out by going to flickr.com. And normally this would go right to my Flickr page, but I logged out and I'm going to open a new account to walk you through it. So hit the sign in button, create a new account, put your information in here. Please do try to use your real name for your Yahoo username, because that'll make it a lot easier for me to search for and find your photos. Password needs to be between 8 and 32 characters. Use both upper and lowercase letters and use numbers. All right, now I'm going to pause because you guys don't need to know how old I am, and I think you can figure out how to fill out the rest of this. And it'll take you right to the Flickr webpage. Click Next. You can connect through Facebook if you want. I'm going to choose not to do that. And it'll take you to the Flickr intro page. As you can see, there's some featured photographs on here that you can go down and look at. Get some pretty impressive photos on Flickr. And I do encourage you to explore photos and connect with not only your classmates, but other photographers on Flickr. Now that you have your Flickr account opened up, it's time to upload some photos. There's a number of ways you can upload photos to your Flickr account. But the most straightforward way is to simply hit this upload button up here. Now we just click on choose photos and videos. And we just go right to the folder where we want to upload prints from on our PC. So I told you to upload at least 3 or 4 photos and post them to our assignment group. You can upload more if you want. And one of the photos should be a picture of yourself. So I'm going to open all these photos and put them on and upload them. At this point, you can change your titles. You can also do that later and put in a description. You can do that for all of them. Or you can simply upload them and change your titles later. You can also add tags and add them to albums, which we'll show you how to do later. Okay, this is all I'm going to do for now. I can work on some of the other things later. And I'm just going to click on Upload Photos. Click Upload. It'll take a while to upload this many photos, so we're going to pause the video at this point, and we'll come back after we've uploaded all our photos. Once all your photos have loaded, Flickr will take you to your photo stream. You can see all the photos I loaded are now up on my photo stream. If we want to take a closer look at them, we can double-click on the photos. We can use this arrow key to make it larger. And then at least if you have a PC, if you hit the F11 key, you can bring it to full screen. That's actually me there in the middle when I was a freshman riding my horse in Mountain Patrol on the Cook campus. Fortunately, I've lost some weight since then. Okay, so we can scroll through our pictures. It's my cat Zeus, some common mergansers, sunflower on the Cook campus, another view of the Cook campus, yet another view of the Cook campus. This is Hellier Woods, a deer I caught out in the woods, an eastern bluebird, the Clinton Mill, and the Ken Lockwood Gorge. If we want to go back to our photo stream, we can just click this arrow down. And this will actually let us do more editing if we want to do it. We can add a description if we want. If we want to go back and look at all of our photos, you can just click on the U. And it takes you back to your photo stream. Now you can see we can navigate over here in Flickr. And I'll take you to my regular Flickr page at some point. But let's show you how to do some mass editing. So if you want to do mass editing, make sure you're on your photo stream by clicking either you or your photo stream. Go over to these three little dots, which is a place where you can often do some additional work in Flickr. Click Organize. Let's do some tags. Okay, I'm going to put all the photos up that were taken on Cook Campus. I'm going to add a tag. I'll use quotes to make it a single tag that says Cook Campus. Let's also put in Rutgers University. Rutgers and University will be separate tags, but that's okay. I'll put in New Jersey, and that I want as a single tag. Let's just add tags. Now what I want to do is create an album of my Rutgers University photos. So I'll create a new album, and we'll just call this Cook Campus. I could add more of a description if I want. Click Save. Okay, now let's go back to our photo stream. And I've already saved everything, so I'll say okay. I can go up to albums, and we'll see I have an album that just includes the shots of the Cook campus. To get back to my full photo stream again, I can just click on the U. And you can click on U to get back to your photo stream pretty much from anywhere. We've accomplished the first part of the assignment. We've created our Flickr account. We've uploaded our photos to Flickr. I've shown you how to edit your photo information. And we've learned how to tag photos and create albums. One thing I do appreciate when you upload your photos to Flickr is that you label them. This is particularly important with assignment photos. When you upload your photos, you're going to want to upload them either directly from your camera or from your computer. If you upload photos from somewhere like Facebook, there are going to be problems in that I'm not going to be able to see what's known as the EXIF data. EXIF means Exchangeable Image File Format. And that gives me information that I'm going to need to see on some of your assignments. Like, for example, what your f-stop is, what speed you took the photo at, what ISO setting you use, what the camera focal length was. Now, you may not know what any of this data is at this point, and that's fine. By the time the class is over, you will understand what all these things mean. For your first photos, it doesn't really matter where you upload them from, because those photos could have been taken at any point in time, and I'm not going to need to see this data. But in the future, make sure that I can see this data and that it's no way hidden. Another part of your assignment was to put your profile on Flickr. And to do that, you're going to go back to your photo stream, click on You, and go over to these three little dots on the side and down to Profile. Click on Edit Your Profile Information. Change it to Eastern Standard Time. And I'm going to put in a very brief description because you don't want to wait while I type in a longer one. I expect yours to be a little bit more involved. Tell me about yourself, why you're taking this class, what kind of camera you have, what kind of experience you have as a photographer, and whether or not you've ever used Photoshop before. You can tell me other interesting things about yourself as well. And don't worry if some of the students in the class seem to have a lot more experience than you do. This class is really meant for beginners. You can edit some other information in here. I recommend that you don't edit your privacy information because I'm going to need to be able to see your photographs, and so are your fellow classmates. If you already have a Flickr account and you want to keep some of the photos in that private, then I recommend that you set up a new Flickr account just for this class. So I'm not going to do anything here, and I'm just going to hit the back button. One thing you might want to do right away is personalize your buddy icon, because otherwise you're just going to have this generic camera. I can show you how to do that. Let me choose my Flickr photos. I think this picture of my cat Zeus will make a pretty good buddy icon. Notice the little square up in the left-hand corner. You're just going to pull that square down and reshape it over the portion of the picture that you want to use as your buddy icon. I'm going to make this square just large enough to fit Zeus in and make it the icon. We've got a Flickr account set up. Let me go back to my main page. What I want to do right now is follow my other account because that's the one that you guys are going to be following. So I'll show you how to set me up as one of your contacts and follow me. And you can do that for some other members in your class too. I'd see you guys following each other's work. You also need to post some photos to the assignment group. Best way to follow me and sign up for the assignments group and the general group is to log on to eCollege. So ecollege.rutgers.edu. And you may have more than one course in eCollege, accessing the photography course, which brings me to the course homepage. You'll see that I have the course set up by weeks. I run the course every week from Sunday through Saturday. So if you want to make sure that you're getting everything in on time and keeping up with your assignments, it's a good idea to go in to eCollege every week, check the week we're in, and there'll be an assignments for the week. Click on the assignments, and it'll tell you what you're going to need to accomplish that week. I'll say more on navigating eCollege for the video in the second week, but right now we want to make sure we're following me, Penny Carlson. You should read the other information on this page, but in order to follow me on Flickr, you just need to go down to the area where I've given you the link to my photo stream. Click on the link. And unfortunately, through eCollege, it's not quite as straightforward as a normal link would be. However, if you click on the area that says "Please click here," it'll then take you to my link. Then just press the plus sign under follow. I'm going to make you guys also friends, which may let us share a little more information. So if you want to make me a friend, you just click this little arrow over to the right and check off the friend. And that's it. You're following me now. I'll see that you're following me. I'll know that you've set up your account, and I will then follow you. Let's go back to eCollege. I have two Flickr groups. The first group is going to be for assignments that you're going to post during the semester. I may also have you post those assignments to eCollege so it establishes a date and time that you turn things in. I am going to want you to post your photos to Flickr so that your classmates can see what you're doing and you can interact. So let's join the assignment group first. So we'll click on that and the redirect. You'll see I've posted some photos into the group already. And you're going to click on Join Group. I only want people that are in this class posting to this group, so I am going to need to approve you for the group. So just send me a quick message with your name. Click Send This, and I'll get your message and we'll approve you as a member of the group. You're going to need to wait for me to approve you as a member of the group before you'll be able to actually post your assignments to the group. Now let's go back to eCollege, and we'll do the same thing for the other group. This is a perpetual group for students in this class, so you'll see things that students from previous semesters have posted, and I hope that you'll continue to use this group after you finish the class. You're going to do the same thing as you did with the last group. As long as you have your name in your Flickr account, you don't really have to send me much of an email. Now you're just going to have to wait until I approve your group memberships. Once I've added you to the assignment groups, you're going to need to post between 3 and 5 photos to the assignment group and post whatever you want to the other group. So you can go up to your group list and you'll see that I'm now in two groups. Okay, so let me choose the Fall 2014 assignment group. And I'm going to add photos. So I'm just going to click on this add photo icon. I'm going to pick a couple of these photos to add. I want one of the photos to be of yourself. I'm kind of cheating here because this is an old photo, but you'll see me plenty of times in videos. And we'll go add to group. Now, here's a couple of problems. I don't have this one labeled. Make sure you label the stuff that you add to the group. Doesn't hurt to add a description, but I'm not going to do that right now. If you needed to do a specific thing in an assignment and you had several photographs, make sure I know which photograph is which. I'm going to add a description to this one so you know which person is me. I'm on the horse in the middle, and I did ride on mounted patrol back when I was a freshman here many years ago. If I want to go back to the group, I just click over here. So now I've added three photos to the group, and you can see some other photos that I previously added. Mine will be at the bottom. I'm going to show you a few more things about navigating Flickr. I guess one thing we can show you now is you see that little three up here. If I click this, it'll take me to my Flickr mail. And if I've got that icon up there, it means I have some unread mail. And you can check your mail out in here. To show you some of the other information you can access in Flickr, I'm going to go to my regular Flickr page. All right, here's my regular Flickr web page, and this will be the one where you're following me. You can see that Professor Penny Carlson is now following me, so I'm going to follow Professor Penny Carlson, just like I'll follow you guys. Some other information you can access would be your Flickr mail, which I just showed you. Help and settings over in here. If you have a number of contacts, when you log in, you're going to see photos from your contacts rather than random photos. Whenever you want to go to your page, you just click you and it takes you to your photo stream. Now the other thing I've done is I've set up a whole bunch of albums. So if you want to see some of my various albums, go to albums. You can see some of my favorite shots. You'll notice that a lot of my photos really kind of pop. Well, that's because I post-processed them. And let's bring this picture up. I'll hit the F11 key to get rid of all the other stuff and make it full screen. A lot of my landscape photographs use a process called high dynamic range photography. And I actually use three shots of the exact same scene. I'm not manipulating the scene. To give the photo more depth in its highlights and shadows. So that's something that you'll learn how to do during this course, to make high dynamic range photographs. Let's go back with my photo stream. We can see some other stuff that we've got up here. You can favorite people's photographs. The photographs that you've made favorites are going to come up. You can order photo books. The one thing you might want to check out is Flickr Explore. And there'll be certain photographs that are featured every day. And that's a good place to kind of go through and really look at some outstanding photographs of other Flickr members. And it's pretty amazing if one of your photos get featured. Let's see, we'll go back to my photo stream. This is my most recent photo that got featured. And you see that I've got almost 12,000 views. And 115 people have faved it. So you get a lot of traffic if your photo gets featured in Flickr Explore. So fool around with Flickr. Have some fun with it. I have contacts from all over the world. Make new friends that you never get to see. But make sure that you interact with some of your classmates on Flickr. I think you'll find in this class that you actually get to know some of your fellow classmates better than you get to know them in a regular class, because we're going to be talking online, we're going to be viewing each other's photographs, and you can go through and make comments on photographs. You can see this one's got a lot of comments just down here. So comment on your friends' photographs. I'll comment on your photograph. Feel free to comment on my photographs. I hope you'll have a lot of fun in this class. I hope you'll have a lot of fun using Flickr. And I hope it's something that you'll continue to do after the class is over.